Hey, it's Paul from howtoplaybass.com. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to play the bass line for Buffalo Soldier by Bob Marley. Nice, easy song, a lazy swing eighth note kind of a feel. Very simple, not a massive amount of notes, but one of those songs that feels great to play. Aston family man Barrett, who played bass with Bob Marley, was a master at coming up with these simple yet infectious bass lines. Really, really cool stuff. Before we go and look at the intro, if you're not a subscriber to my free monthly e-zine, click the link underneath this video if you're watching on YouTube, head over to my website, hit the subscribe button and subscribe to my free monthly e-zine. You'll get a sequence of four video and PDF lessons that are unique to subscribers. And also there's a free monthly video and PDF tutorial, again, also unique for subscribers. So it's definitely worth doing. It'll cost your email address. So click the link below, go do that. Let's move on with the lesson. Let's look at the intro for Buffalo Soldiers. The intro to Buffalo Soldiers, very straightforward. It's just one note played in swing eighth notes for four bars. The note is A, fifth fret of the E string. Two, three, four. Then you'd be into the verse. Now, Aston Barrett plays with a very kind of lazy swing eighth note feel. The best way to cop it is to learn all the parts of the song with the video and then put them together so that you've got the song memorised and then play along with the original. That's the best way to do it. Let's move on and look at the next section, which is the verse. Okay, the verse is a 16-bar section, features a 4-bar pattern that's just played over and over, or played four times. I'll play it through a couple of times and we'll talk through the notes. Two, three, four. Okay, let's talk through the notes of that section. Okay, the first two bars are just A again, fifth fret of the E string. Then the next bar is two F sharps, fourth fret of the D string, E, seventh fret of the A string, D, fifth fret of the A string, back to A, fifth fret of the E string. And watch your durations of those, of the E, D and A. Those notes should be quite short and staccato. And the last bar doesn't play on beat one. You've got F sharp to octave A, fourth and seventh frets of the D string, starting on beat two, and then two eighth notes, pair of swing eighth notes of A, fifth fret of the E string on beat three. So I'll play that 4-bar pattern again so you can hear that coming in on beat two of the fourth bar. Two, three, four. Then that plays four times, and then after the first verse you get to a little pre-chorus section. Let's go and look at that. After the first verse we've got a little 8-bar pre-chorus section with the lyric "If you know your history." Play it with the metronome, talk through the notes. Three, four. Okay, then you'll be back to the verse. So let's talk through those notes. First bar, you've got three Ds, fifth fret of the A string, open A string, and two C sharps, the fourth fret of the A string, and a G sharp, fourth fret of the E string. Then it repeats that. And the third bar is three C sharps, three C sharps, G sharp, fourth frets of the A and E strings respectively, and then B at the second fret of the A string, then two hits on F sharp at the second fret of the E string. So play through that 4-bar pattern. And that pattern just repeats. Then it goes to verse 2. Now, after verse 2, it plays that pre-chorus pattern again. Then there's another verse. And after the third verse, we've got a variation of the verse line under the lyric of Y-I-I, Y-I-I-I. So let's go and look at that section. Okay, this Y-I-I-I section, it's an 8-bar section, 4-bar pattern, very similar to the basic verse pattern. Two notes have changed, that's all it is. I'll play the 4-bar pattern and then we'll talk through the changes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. That last bar is where the changes were. In the verse, it goes F sharp, A, two low A's at the fifth fret of the E string. But in the YII section, it goes D, E, and two A's. Play that 4-bar pattern again. And that last bar is the only change from the verse, so you can get all the notes from the verse. It plays that 4-bar pattern twice, and then it goes to a little bridge section. Let's go and look at that. Okay, the bridge section. Play it with the metronome, then we'll talk through it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Back into the verse. Okay, so those two 4-bar patterns there that are similar, not identical though. The first two bars are just F sharp, second fret of the E string. And the third bar is this, which is D, D, A, D, E. And locations are D is the fifth fret of the A string, D, open A string, back to D, E at the 7th fret of the A string, and then you've got C sharp twice, quite short again, watch your note lengths on those, that's the 4th fret of the A string. So I'll play that 4-bar pattern, starting with F sharp. And the second 4 bars starts out the same. But the second two bars are different. You've got two D's. That's all D, fifth fret of the A string. Then you've got open A string, D, E, D and E, fifth and seventh frets of the A string. Then you've got C sharp, fourth fret of the A string, and finish on E, seventh fret of the A string. Again, watch those note durations on some of those notes. So play that second 4 bars again. And those are all the parts you need. If you go to my website and go to the songs page and find this tutorial embedded on its own page, you'll either find it via searching chronologically or via searching by artist stroke bass player. On that page, I'll put a detailed roadmap so you can put these 5 pieces together and play through the entire song.